In the days of yore, many saints and many sages meditated and prayed for years and years together to get a mere glimpse, a mere fleeting glimpse of the Lord. But all of us sitting here, have been lucky to have been born in the same era, to have walked the same earth, to have seen the Lord, to have heard the Lord, to have touched the Lord, and have our lives touched by the Lord. When a student enters the portal of the Swiss Atisai Institute of Higher Learning, they take with them a little backpack. The backpack is used to fill memories which they collect along the way. Memories big and small. The big memories are the ones that are life-changing, but the small memories are the ones that make a mark. When I first entered the institute, Swami looked at me and said, "Hey, Bombay boy, come here." From then onwards, my ears used to yearn. When will he call me Bombay boy and ask me to come ahead? As time moved on, I took advantage of grabbing Pad Namaskar whenever I had the opportunity to take. One fine day, I was about to grab his feet when he grabbed hold of my cheek first. He twisted my cheek and said, "Naughty boy, very naughty boy." I took advantage of the growing proximity, and one fine day I decided to pester him. I said, "Swami, my parents are coming. Please speak to them, please speak to them, please speak to them." And then he said, "Hey, when we look around, we crave that warmth. We look externally craving that warmth, but then we tell our hearts, Chal Re Man Apne Dham. We tell our hearts to return back to the source. The source which is filled with a spring of love that he planted while we were studying there." Now, music has always been close to the heart. It is also close to the heart of all the devotees around the world, inspiring them and moving devotees around the world. Today, I have the privilege of introducing three brothers who have flown all the way from Puttaparthi to offer a bouquet of love, to offer a bouquet of gratitude to Swami, to offer a bouquet of music to Swami. As I introduce them, I would like them to come and take the stage. I would like to introduce Brother Siddhartha Raju. Brother Siddhartha hails from Chennai and joined the Sri Satyasai Institute of Higher Learning in 2006 for the MBA program. Thereafter, as advised by Swami, he completed his master's in English at a college in Chennai and then returned to Bharti. He is now an assistant professor in the English department. Brother Siddhartha is a talented dramatist, a gifted speaker, a singer as well. He has written, directed, and acted in several plays held in the Divine Presence. Prior to joining Swami's Institute, Brother Siddhartha was also a part of the Sundaram Bhajan group for almost a decade. He is now an integral member of the Prashanti Mandir Bhajan group. I'd like you to put your hands together for Brother Siddhartha. I would like to introduce Brother Amay Deshpande. Brother Amay hails from Maharashtra and was a student in the primary school in Bharti from 1989 to 1993. He did his bachelor's in commerce from Bangalore University in 2000, after which he pursued a career in chartered accountancy in Bangalore from 2000 to 2003. He was a member of the Vrindavan Bhajan group and a Vrindavan Sevadal from 1999 to the year 2003. In 2003, he joined the MBA finance program at the Sri Satyasai Institute. Thereafter, at Swami's advice, he joined the Masters in Philosophy program in 2006, graduating in 2007 with a gold medal. Brother Amay has also conceived, written, directed, and acted in many plays in the Divine Presence. Brother Amay Deshpande has recently completed his PhD in the area of corporate strategy and performance management at the Department of Management Studies in the Sri Satyasai Institute of Higher Learning. Please put your hands together for Brother Amay. Alright, next we have a very, very special brother here from all the way from Puttaparthi. There are some people who would argue that the name itself is sufficient and I need not go into further introducing this brother. But for the uninitiated, I would like Brother Amay to introduce this very special brother to us.
Offering our loving pranams at the divine lotus feet of our ever-present Swami and invoking his presence and his benediction this beautiful evening, respected elders and dear brothers and sisters, Sairam to all of you. Many years back, it was a lovely evening. The aarti had been taken and I was gliding out of the Kulwant Hall when I was accosted by one of the young boys who said, "Are you Ravi Kumar?" And I said, "No, I'm not Ravi Kumar." He may be coming. He says, can I get an opportunity to meet him?" I said, "Yeah, sure." And so as Brother Ravi was coming, I asked Ravi brother, there's this boy who wants to meet you. And obviously, as humble as he is, he said, "Yeah, who's that?" And so this brother came, and I still remember this brother, this absolute stranger, just held Ravi brother's hand and just started crying. And then he went on to narrate. He said that he went through some really, really difficult times in his life. And it was at that time that he was introduced to Bhagwan through Sai Bhajans. And ever since he started hearing Sai Bhajans, there was one voice that stood out from every other voice. And in the darkness of his life, if there was a ray of hope, if there was a ray of love, it was this voice. And when he finally got a chance to meet the source of this voice, he was just not able to control the tears of joy that flowed from his eyes. To me, that pretty much sums up what Brother Ravi is to all of us. To the both of us over here, our personal icons, and our dear elder brother that he has been, he's a mentor. And just to give you a perspective, he'll of course tell you his story, but just to give you a perspective, if I tell you that there is a person who has sung in the direct divine presence of Swami from the age of 6, he has sung for the past 35 years in the direct divine presence, has sung over 20,000 bhajans in the direct divine presence. He is the longest ever singer in Prashantilam. We were actually making a little experiment to know, was it Raja Reddy sir who has sung the most, or was it Iradi sir who has sung the most? Iradi sir has sung for more than 50 years in Swami's presence. But at a stretch, uninterrupted, from the age of 6 to his current age, okay, if there is one person who has sung in Prashantilam, in the Sanctum Sanctorum, the headquarters of the Sai world, it is only Brother Ravi. And so with this video, opportunity to, even before I called him, I thought I'd tell, because otherwise he'd be standing over here and shut me up. So that is Brother Ravi. And of course, I mean, this was an introduction I thought was necessary. Of course, no introduction. Also, to add on, Brother has dedicated his life to the Sri Sathya Sai Institute of Higher Medical Sciences, where he is the manager of the radiology department, which is also a thing that he does. Just like all of Swami's students, Swami expects every student to be a multifaceted personality. They should be good in everything. You should be a Zakir Hussain on the tabla, you should be a Sachin Tendulkar in the ground, and you should be an Albert Einstein in the laboratory. That's what Swami expected most of his students. And of course, what Swami expects and what we rise up to is two completely different things. But that's how Swami expects us to be, and that's what we aspire to be. So with that little introduction, we will begin. And first of all, let us take this opportunity to thank each and every one of the alumni brothers. It's so wonderful to see so many of our brothers right here, all the way in Singapore, which is like a home. That's the first thing. And the second thing was such a beautiful, beautiful video to start with. I think it was so heart-touching. And really, it captures the essence of what we are all trying to build up over here. The entire build-up of all our lives is probably that little song where he just says, "Swami, this is our bond of love. This is our relationship of love that we want to build with you." So thank you so much for, and in fact, there's nothing more to say. So thank you so much, Sanya. In fact, every one of us who are here, in many ways, started off with our little baby steps that we first took towards Swami, isn't it? It's almost like these little rivers that start off somewhere in the mountains and slowly make their way towards the ultimate destination, which is the ocean. And I'm sure that each one of us over here have their own little ways that we took our first steps, that each of our rivers started flowing towards the ultimate destination. But just imagine if on one of these journeys the ocean itself were to come and to hold the hand of the river and say, come, you know, this is the destination. Let me tell you how to get to the destination. How much better will that be, isn't it? And I think in each one of our lives over here, Swami, who is the ocean, has come along and has caught hold of our hands and said, you know, you are taking too much time. Let me give you a shortcut to how you can come and merge into me. And that is what this beautiful song says, that enough we have struggled in this world, enough of this world of attachments, enough of this bondage. Let's break asunder and go back to our source. And we'll make this evening as interactive as possible and just share with you how Swami has held our hands and He continues to hold our hands onto our ultimate destination, which is He Himself. And I'm sure that each one of you will be able to recollect your own little moments in life, those magical moments when Swami held your hands and took and continues to take you along towards Him, towards that destination. So let me first begin with asking Brother Ravi how he came to Swami, because when he came to Swami, most of us were, at least I was not even born. So I would really love to know, Brother Ravi, how did you first come to Swami? What is your first recollection with Bhagwan?
This was in 1978. And I had finished my second standard of schooling, wherever I was doing in Karnataka in India. And my father got to know that Swami had started a school in Ooty. And he was very keen that I should join that school in Ooty. So we were going in a car. There was supposed to be an entrance exam in Ooty sometime in August 1978. And we were going in our, we were driving along in our ambassador car. And then as we passed Mysore, and then there is this forest we come to, this Bandipur and Mudumalai forest on the way to Ooty. So just as we were nearing Bandipur forest, a car overtook our car. And it was a Mercedes-Benz. So I was pretty impressed. You know, sitting in an ambassador car, you get impressed with a Mercedes-Benz. Said, wow, lovely car. I was telling my father, wonderful car. He said, yes. Another Mercedes-Benz also overtook our car. And I said, wow, two in a row. And then the Mercedes car, the second Mercedes car, the curtains parted. Then we could see a halo of hair. And then we were dumbstruck. I asked my father, is this Swami? You know, we were going to Ooty and then we didn't even know Swami would be coming along in the same path. Father said yes. Then he told the driver who was driving the car, chase the Mercedes-Benz. Easier said than done.
Especially in an ambassador.
So then luckily for us, Swami stopped in a guest house in Bandipur forest. And then so obviously we also stopped. We were about two cars which were behind Swami. We were so lucky. We got down from the car and we were standing with folded hands. Swami had a few of the brothers from Vrindavan. He was taking them along to Ooty. So Swami got down from the car and he looked at us. And then he asked in Kannada, which is the language in Karnataka. He asked, Yellinda Bandindira, where are you coming from? So my father said, Swami, we are coming from Coorg, from Madikeri Swami. Swami said okay and went into the guest house. And we were standing outside and mother had a doubt. Mother asked my father, see, Swami knows everything. Father said, yes, Swami knows everything. What is your doubt? He knows that we speak Tamil at home. We are Tamilians. Why did he speak to us in Kannada? Father said, see, that is not for us to ask. Swami speak to us. We speak Kannada as well. So Swami speak in whichever language he wants to. So that was fine. Then Swami sent us prasadam, which as lunch, and we sat outside and we had lunch. And then Swami, in this very inimitable way, in this sweet way, in which he opens our eyes to things. This is our first interaction with Swami. He comes out from the guest house, stares at us, looks at my mother, and asks in Tamil, "Saptacha." Of course, food was very, very tasty. But more tasty was this lesson of omnipresence of Swami that we got then and there. And of course, we were very happy. And then we again chased the Mercedes-Benz car right up to Ooty, and we were thrilled that Swami, and we found out from Swami's party that actually Swami was going to Ooty. So I went, we went there, and I wrote the entrance exam. My mother did not want me to join the school. My father wanted me to join the school.
That's an interesting fact there. Huh? Mother did not want
me. Did not want, yeah. I think most, if not all, mothers don't want their children away from them. Especially, you know, tiny tots, they don't want to let them in a hostel. I wrote the entrance exam, and then Swami was in OT. And then they had put up on the notice board the list of boys and girls who were selected. And mother was seeing the list and she was so happy, you know, 15, 20, my name was not there. There were only 30 kids who were selected. And number 30 is my name. And then father is elated and my mother is, you know, grief stricken. And but it's okay, I am selected now, there's no choice. You know, she can't even tell father, no, we'll take this guy back. So I'm put into the school, and mother was literally heartbroken. And
I think this point was the first time that Brother Ravi was in fact joining the school, and it was the, I think the first evening. First evening, and Ooty is, by the way, for those of you who don't know, Ooty is a hill station, so it is supposed to be a cold place. So I think Brother Ravi, little tiny dot, he was wearing a monkey cap. I don't know whether you know what's a monkey cap. It covers your head, nose, everything other than your eyes. Everything is covered. And so he was sitting with that.
And there was this hall, something like this, almost a hall as big as this. And then Swami was sitting here in the middle of this hall on the throne. And then I was sitting right at the back. I was at the back and all the other kids were sitting here. And then suddenly Swami calls from here, he says, "A monkey cap." So there were a few other kids also wearing monkey cap. I was also wearing one. So I was looking around. Yeah, who's Swami talking to? Then he pointedly looked at me and said, "You, monkey cap, get up." So I stood up there. I was all of 7 years old. And he said, "Sing something." So he just, there are no coincidences with God. You know, it's a coincidence is a miracle where God decides to be anonymous. So I had started singing at home just the previous year. Father had taught me a couple of bhajans. And obviously what we are singing in our puja room, sitting at home, wherever we are, Swami is hearing. So the first time Swami is seeing, he just says, "Get up," and he says, "Sing." And so in 1978, I don't know, it was August 8th, that was the first bhajan I sang. My favorite bhajan was "Bolo Narayana Jai Jai Vithala." So I sang that, and Swami said, "Nice, sit down." So that was the wonderful incident, the opportunity that he gave to me to start singing for him.
Right. So I think it doesn't end there, because this was his part of the story, but then there was still the mother who was, you know, grief-stricken. What do you do about that? Right? She's also an important stakeholder in this whole play which is going on.
Yeah. So this happened. Swami asked me to sing, but I was in the hostel. I was not with my parents. They were staying in a hotel outside. And next day for darshan, the night after I joined the hostel, what happened was, I think my father puts it very nicely. He says, in the hotel room, he was facing one wall, and he was also in his own way, he was feeling happy and a little sad. But my mother was facing the other side, and she was crying all night. She cried. The next morning they come for darshan, and Swami goes around, he goes to my father and he tells him, "Don't worry, I will take care of your son." He goes to the lady side, he picks out my mother from the crowd and he tells her, "Don't worry, I'll take care of your son." So no parent needs a greater assurance than this. Then Swami, then the Lord that you trust in, the Lord in whom you put your everything, he comes and tells you, "I'll take care of your son." Obviously, parents. So that was the last tear that my mother shed about me leaving them.
I think it's been 38 years since then, and Swami continues to take care of his brother, just like
he takes care of all of us. For some of us, there is this verbal assurance. For some, there is no verbal assurance. But we think of him, and he takes care of us. And at this juncture, we'll sing a song just to say how Swami, as a mother, how he takes care of us. and that is the love he showers on us.
In fact, the song is very well known, but for some of you who don't know about it, it was in fact brother who actually first was one of the first few singers of this song in front of Swami. And a legend in fact moves along that when Swami came back to Parthi after that visit to Uti, Swami said, you know, there is one very good singer, and he sang a beautiful song. And it was after brother Ravi came to Prashanthi Nilayam, Swami in fact made brother Ravi sing this particular song, and it's a very beautiful song. We will sing this right now.
Towards him.